Hi guys, now it's time to start a new project. And the new project is going to be build a tube notcher. And I'm really desperate for one because I've been using my little bench mill and it's not good at all for that kind of drilling or hole sawing because it's not so stable. It takes a lot of toll and it's very difficult if you want to notch at an angle. And I happened to stumble across this at my old work, and this would be perfect to clamp the tubes with. So this I got, and I got the two bearings and I got a housing for the bearings. So the first thing I'm going to do is turn out the holes for the bearings and put them in here and make an axle, because I haven't really decided yet of how I'm going to build it, but I'm going to start with this and see what I come up with. So let's go over to the lathe. Now I mounted the bearings in the housing, so now it's time to make up a shaft to put in here to drive the hole saw. And I want, this is exactly 20 millimeters, and I want it slightly under so it slides easy inside and out in the bearings when I drill. So I'm gonna put it up in the lathe and grind off some, a couple of hundred millimeters just. Yeah, here we go. The spindle is ready. It's threaded on the hole saw side, and on this side I drilled a hole and used the stop screw, and I cut off a piece from an Allen wrench and put in there so I can change it if it wears out. So that is finished, and I have been thinking about how I want to be able to angle it, and I've been thinking about how I'm going to make the locking work, and I come up with, I'm going to take this pipe and weld this, which is bored in the on this side is bored out and on this side is threaded. So I'm going to weld this on here. And after I weld it, I'm going to cut everything like this, cut through this. And I'm going to attach this to the V-block side. And on this side, I'm going to use this axle and mount the spindle on the axle so I can easy just lose this and turn it to the angle I want and lock it very easily. I think this is going to be quite good actually. So let's start weld and cut and mount on plates and stuff. I had to re-weld this one because this one came too close to the center of the axle. So when I'm going to mount this to the pipe and I'm going to do some angle hole sawing, the hole saw is coming so far away from the vise. So I move this further back so I can have this more to the centrum here where the pipe is going to be. Because for the stuff I usually make, I have often short pipes, so I want to be able to saw as close to the vise as possible. But I forget to film it, but I just cut it off and welded it further back on this plate. Yeah, let's continue with the vise. There we go. Now everything is welded together and line up perfectly. I must have measured something wrong because I had to put the 1 millimeter plate, if you see it, between the wee block and the plate. So, but now it's perfect. So now it's time to make a screw to lock the material, and I'm going to use a threaded bar, cut it to the right length, and make a little washer that is going to attach to the front of the screw here, and weld some kind of handle in the back. This screw I would like to have, I would like to not have to use any tools to adjust the angle and to lock in the material, but this screw gets blocked by this one if I have it in this angle, which I'm sure I never will, but I'm still not sure how to make this one. It's super easy to just use a little wrench, but I have to figure something out for that one. Now I turned down the screw and made a little groove there in the front. And I made this aluminium washer that I drilled in, and I bored and threaded this little stop screw that I turned, grinded a little point, so I made it a little pointy, so it hits the groove on the screw so that it can rotate, but it won't pop off. So it can rotate like this, but it stuck. It turned out very good, and now I can weld the handle. And if I weld the handle, I must be able to take this off to mount it, I think this solution is very good. Plus that I got a very flat surface here if I want to put some square tubes in here. It's no problem at all. It will be really good. It mounts really good and correct itself so it gets a nice 90 degree angle there. Because it's very good to be able to cut both round bar and square and maybe some L shapes and so. There we go. This worked out perfect. Now I can lock it no problem at all, and even if it's positioned over the screw, it's no problem to lock and loosen it. So that turned out really good. And if I want, I can adjust with some washers between here if I like it in the other way for some reason. And it's no problem to take it off either. So now that is ready. Now the thing left to do is to make an aluminum plate here with the degrees on it, so I know which angle I'm notching in. And that is something I can do on my CNC router, but first I'm going to make a little cardboard template to try out what design I want or how it's going to look. Then I'm making a CAD drawing of that and later on a program for my router. But let's start making the template. Now the machine is set up, so now it's time to go up and make a program. And my zero is in this corner, and I also measured in a carbide radius mill, diameter 4 with a 2 mm radius. So I'm going to both do the engraving of the angles and cut out the profile with the same mill, and I hope it will go well. So now let's go to the computer. Go. Now it's ready for some paint, so let's clean it and mask it up and paint it with some nice color. Go, some fresh paint and fully assembled again. I'm really happy with how this plate turned out. It's so fun to have the router working this good, if you consider how cheap of a tool it is. Yeah, so now we're going to try it out and test it. And I'm very anxious to see how it's performing. There, now we're going to try it out. I'm starting with a 20 mm, I think it is, 22 mm holesaw. That is a little used, but it's in quite good shape. And my trusty old Milwaukee. And we start at 0 degrees, a 22 mm steel pipe. And some cutting oil is always good to have. exactly no problem at all. It's so very stable, rigid, because I used to do this in a drill press, and I had always such a problems with its teeth. That it got hooked into the material and broke off teeth and broke off the material, and it was an enormous vibration in the machine. I actually destroyed the gear in my drill press with this with the holesaw. Now we're going to test and make a little angle cut in. Oh, 30 degrees. We have to do 30 degrees. Yes, try. Oh, it cut a little in the last, but very good, no vibration or the tooth gets caught in the material, no problem like that at all. Now I'm going to try this little feature. We put it back to zero, there we are, zero, and we elevate it like this. Ten millimeters and zero. This is also very useful when you're connecting pipes. A little more oil. Went also really really good, no problem at all. This is perfect. And we're going to try some square tube. I only got some aluminum, but that will have to do. It's 20 by 20, what is it, 2.5 millimeter. Put it back at the, when it's in the bottom, it's centered with the centrum of the device. No problem there either. Perfect. Yeah, I can say that I'm very pleased with this machine I build, or tool. This is going to be very useful. This is going to be very useful in my shop when I'm doing some notching. Hope you think this was a great tool and that you're interested in making something of your own. So please leave a comment in the comment section if you have any questions.